डेल्टा, प्रॉब्लम वन इज
सर डेल्टा टी माइनस 10।
डेल्टा टी माइनस 10। तो टू ड्रॉ आई हैव सेड दैट प्लॉट दिस सिग्नल, ओके द सिग्नल, प्लॉट द सिग्नल डेल्टा टी माइनस 10। यार इट इज फॉल अंडर द फर्स्ट ऑपरेशन दैट इज टाइम शिफ्टिंग एंड आई हैव सेड दैट दिस टी नॉट, ओके दिस टी नॉट इज पॉजिटिव मीन्स 10। सिंस इफ सिग्नल इज समथिंग टी माइनस 10 और टी माइनस 2 something minus is there, then you have to shift the signal to the right, okay? To draw this signal, to draw this signal, you should know to draw what is, you should know that to draw the delta signal. You should know what is delta, okay? Delta signal. So delta signal, we learned that it has spikes at zero, okay? T equal to zero. You can represent one also because it's this one represent the area of the signal, delta T. Okay. When then delta T minus 10, I am saying that it is shifted to the right of the, it is shifted to the right. Okay. So it's come up to here. This is represented as a y axis. You can write like this only. But here you should write 10. After 10 second or 10 unit, the signal shifted. Okay, and second problem, can you say,
sir, R of T plus 5.
R of T plus 5. Question may come. Okay, plot R of T plus 5. So to do, plot this signal, you should know what is R. Okay. And the functional as well as graphical representation you should know, then you can able to plot these signals. Okay, first of all you plot RT. RT is we know that is a ramp signal. Okay, ramp signal is means it has constant slope. Slope is one for the positive time duration. Okay, and I have said when t plus 5 is there, if here t not equal to minus 5, so if plus something is there with the t, the signal with the signal would shift to the left. So this is minus 5. This is r of t minus 5. Okay. So you can see that the signal is shifted to the left, okay, and the slope of both the signal is same. Slope should not be different. Here, little bit by looking, we can see that our slope it's a little, but it should be same. Okay, slope should be same. What is the third problem?
Sir, del of t plus 5 plus del of t minus 4.
T plus 5 minus del of minus or plus?
Plus sir, del of plus sir.
Plus del of?
Del of minus 4.
T minus 4. Okay.
So sir, T plus 4 and T minus 4 sir.
Okay. To here addition of the signal. This fourth property already come here. The signal addition. No problem. To draw this signal, you should know what is delta. Okay, how to plot a delta signal? I have shown already delta is this. Okay, when delta t plus 4, then spike, this is the y axis. Okay, a spike come at the t equal to 4. And when minus is there, it's come at the right side. Okay, this is 4. This is for t minus 4. Okay, this is delta t plus 4. If plus is there, the signal is shifted to the left. This delta signal is shifted to the left to up to minus 4. So our question is to plot summation of these two signals, okay? T means delta t plus 4 plus delta t minus 4 summation. When you sum, you can see that at the positive side of the second wave, second plot, there is no amplitude, but the amplitude is present at the, or spike is present at the first signal. So when you summed up, 0 plus some spike will be again come as a spike. The left side only, also we can find the spike for the second signal. So this is for minus 4, this is for plus 4. So we can find after addition two spikes at the required plot, what is given in the problem, okay? So like that, addition of the signal take place. So I think you have understood the thing. So let's proceed to time scaling, okay? The second operation on the signal, it is called time scaling. You can write for like a definition, the time scaling of a continuous time signal. Continuous time signal. Suppose xt, okay, is represented by yt equal to x of alpha t or a t. You can write anything. Let me write a t, okay? A is a scalar. You can write a constant, okay? So what is scaling means basically? First one is time shifting. We can shift the signal to the right or left. What is scaling means? Okay, you should write time scaling means. Time scaling means compression or expansion. Expansion, compression or expansion of a signal, okay? It can this operation make the signal compress or expand, based on the value of a, okay? So what I am saying, if value a or alpha, you can write a, if a greater than 0, or you can write if a greater than 1, not 0, if a greater than 1, then class here, please take the attendance. Still, your friends are sending request to join the class. Please take attendance and give it to me. I'll take another attendance at the end of the class. Please give somebody still sending the request. Okay, we are discussing about time scaling. Okay, so time scaling formula is given yt equal to x at, and I am saying that time scaling means compression or expansion of a signal, and if a greater than a, then what will be yt? Yt is a compression signal of xt. Okay, it will be compressed. If a positive value of a is there, then the signal will be compressed. Okay, if a greater than 0 and less than 1, okay, something point 0.75, 0.5, 0.1, it is in between the point, then yt is a expansion of a signal. means with respect to the signal xt, the y2 would be expansion. Okay, it will expand its time duration. And the y for a greater than zero, a greater than one, the yt would be a compressed signal. Means the duration of the signal will be compressed. It will be less with respect to the y xt. Okay. So you can able to understand when I give a when I solve a problem or with the graphical representation only, you will able to understand the things clearly. So let me explain with some plot question given that
suppose previous slide. Okay sir, okay.
Suppose problem is a continuous time signal xt is given by this is y axis, okay. Suppose this is xt, okay. This t. This is 2, 4, 6, 0. Suppose the amplitude equal to 4. Okay. And question is plot x of suppose 2t. Okay. The question has come plot suppose x2t. So here since it is multiply with time, this 2 is multiply with time, it fall on the scaling property. Okay. Time scaling property. So you should know what is how to solve this. Okay, you can compare this a 2 with a since you can say since 2 greater than a, or you can say that a equal to 2 greater than 1. Since it is greater than 1, so signal will be compressed. Then signal will be a compressed signal. Okay. Would be a compressed signal. So how to solve? I am saying that you should equate the this new t twice t with the previous signal time instant. Okay, how you compare? I am saying when I t is the time shifting also. I take the similar example I solve there also that you have to compare this. Time, the new time duration with the initial time instant. Okay, you have to equate this twice t equal to first zero. Then the new time will be the new time for the new plot. Compressed signal will be it will be zero only. When you compare this twice t for the two, the new time will be you can say it is one. Okay, when you compare twice t equal to suppose 4, then the new time will be 2. Like that, when you compare twice t equal to 6, then t will be 3. Okay. Now these are the time duration for the x twice t. Okay. So this is t. This is x twice t. Okay. For x twice t, the time instants are 4. 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Our signal will be like this. The amplitude remains same because we are not perform any amplitude scaling or we are not perform any amplitude. Okay. We will not perform any operation on the amplitude. So amplitude will be 4 only. But you can see that the time duration of this new signal, okay, x twice t. The duration is what? It is 0 to 3 only, but earlier it is 0 to 6. So you can say that the when a greater than 1 means the signal is compressed. Compressed means it's reduced is time duration existence of the signal. It exists only for 0 to 3. Okay, but the previous one is exist for 0 to 6. So it is called a compressed signal. Okay. So similar for similar signal, if question make come, plot x of half t. Okay. So can you say what will be the range of this x half t?
0, 4, 8, 12.
0, 4, 8, 12. Okay. So this is for the initially. This is the x t. This is the 6. This 2, 4. Okay. And you should write all the steps. Okay. If this question carry 2 mark, if this question carry 1 mark, thus you can plot the signal directly. X of half t would be how much? The 0, 4, 8, 12. Okay, and amplitude would be remain same 4. Okay, so if anybody has any doubt, you can ask. No doubt. Okay, let me give question. Suppose already we have explained what? We have explained in terms of plot. Okay, what will be the compressed signal? What is will be the expand signal? Okay, let me give like questions in a functional representation. Plot rect of y t. And another question is rect of 1/4 t. With the help of with the concept of this scaling, you should plot this signal. Okay. Can you able to do what is the range for this twice t, and what is the range of this 1/4 t? Can you answer? Able? Do your in your copy. You try first. I'll do. I'll solve this question. But you first do in your copy, and let me give me the answer. Okay, what will be the range for rectangular twice t?
Sir, 1 to -1, -1 to 1.
First one is -1 to 1. Okay, something. I think. This
no, sir, -1/4 to 1/4.
Yes, second one is correct, -1/4 to 1/4. Okay, this is wrong. And what will be the case of this rect 1/4 t?
-2 to 2.
Okay. With the concept of this time scaling. With the concept of this time scaling, okay, y t equal to x a t. I am saying that when a greater than 1, then y t will be a compressed signal, and when a in between 0 to 1, then y t is a expansion signal. Okay, and with this concept, let me solve this problem when functional representation is given. So to solve this question, you should know what is rect signal. Okay, what is rect signal? It is a rectangular pulse signal. Okay, how you can plot a rectangular pulse signal? It is a kind of rectangular signal. Okay, this is a rect. Let first draw a rect t. Okay, this is a rect t. First you draw the rect t, then you can easily solve the question. Okay, as I initially also when I'm going to solve the signal in initial slide, First, I draw the this standard signal del t. Then I draw the shifted signal. In a RAM signal also, I am doing like that only. Then the question become, then the solution, then the procedure become easy, okay? And you can able to solve the question. So after this, first you draw the rack signal, okay? What is rack signal? Rack signal is, amplitude is one, and the existence of this rack signal is minus half to half. This thing you should know first, okay? Then, when you multiply a constant with the t, if constant is greater than one, it is two is greater than one, then signal will be compressed. Signal will be compressed. A compressed version of the original signal, okay? And this compressed version of the original signal. And this compressed signal, how you can find the range? You should divide this range with the this two. You should divide. When you divide, how what you will get? 1/4 to 1/4. It is compressed. That's why you the range will be 1/4 to 1/4. Similarly, what will be the case for 1/4 t? Okay. So it will be expand. Okay. The signal will be expand version of the original signal, means rect of t. Okay. Expand means how you should what? You should multiply it with the this 4. You can say 1/a, you can write like this also. This is a equal to 4 also you can write, because it then you have to multiply this 4 with the half. Then it will minus 2 to 2. Like that also you can understand the things, okay? You can build your concept like that also, that 1/4 means here a is 4. So since it is expand signal, then we have to multiply 4 with the existing minus half to half, okay? So our new signal will be exist for the minus 4 minus 2 to 2. So I think this thing is clear. If anyone has doubt, you can ask.
Sir, once again, explain.
Okay. So here you can see the rect T. It's first of all, to solve this signal, you should know the what is the how to draw a rect signal. Okay, rect T signal. Rect T signal is exist for minus half to half. You should know this. And how this half to half has come, I already explained in the when I explain this rectangular signal, when I explain the elementary signal, there I define the signal and plot the signal of this rect signal. Okay, so now you should write first rect T. That T exists from minus half to half. Okay. Then say that in the question come as rect twice T. Plot a signal rect twice T. Here, this rect is A equal to 2. Okay. Here you can see that A equal to 2 is greater than 1. And I'm saying that when A greater than 1 or constant greater than 1, the signal will be a compressed version. Compressed means the duration of the signal will be less as compared to the previous one. Okay. If duration of the less, then what we'll do? We'll divide this constant, these two, with the original signal. When you divide this half by two, obviously we'll get 1/4. So that's why that signal is exist from minus one by four to 1/4. But in the third plot, or you can say in the second question, the question has come for rect 1/4 t. Here a equal to 1/4, which is less than 1, okay? Which is less than 1. Then you should, multiply with 4 with the existing range. Then you can easily find this minus 2 to 2. It will be expand this half. This minus 2 is greater than this half, no? So when we... you can say the divide also, okay? You can divide also, you can multiply also. You should know how to divide, okay, to get the larger value. Okay, so how I can say, so when you multiply, then you have to multiply half with a 4, then you will get 2. Okay, and if you want to divide half into this 4 by 1, like that also you can say.
Okay sir, understood.
The divide means 1 by 4. Okay, it is means 1 by 2 into 4 by 1. This is 2. Like that you can get the range. Okay.